As far as can you do ruqya for your own self? Yes. And the Prophet ﷺ taught us also before going to sleep to summon our hands and recite the three mu'awwidhat, three last chapters, and blow in them twice and wipe over our face and body as much as we can reach, or as far as we can reach by our hands over our bodies. Okay? The Prophet ﷺ used to recite the ruqya upon his grandsons, Al-Hasan wal-Husayn. And he encouraged us to recite the ruqya on every time, but it is not recommended to ask others to give you ruqya, because there is a sound hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ said there will be 70,000 of my ummah who shall enter paradise without reckoning. Amongst those 70,000, or amongst their traits, that they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do not seek ruqya, they do not ask for ruqya. Their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and confidence is beyond limit, to the extent that they wouldn't ask somebody to pray for them. But if somebody offers, they will welcome that. So, it is recommended when you visit somebody who is sick, or a family member whom you know that he or she is sick, to recite the ruqya upon them. Let's say that you visit somebody who is not your mahram, of the opposite gender. It will be sufficient to stand next to him or her and recite the ruqya. It's also recommended to place your palm on the spot of the pain. That if you are a man doing it for another man, or a woman doing it for another woman, or doing it to a mahram whom you're allowed to touch his or her body, to place your hand on the spot which is aching or suffering, and you recite the ayat, ayatul kursi, al-fatiha, al-mu'awwidhat, and recite the following dua, أعيذك بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما تجد وتحاذر. If you're reciting for another person. If you're reciting for yourself, you say أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما أجد وأحاذر. I seek refuge with Allah in His perfect words against everything I find and everything I'm afraid of or I'm suffering from. والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم.